Hello, you beautiful people. Today we're taking a look at the Microsoft Surface Pro 9. I still think this is one of the nicest looking 2-in-1s you can buy on the market. Fun fact, when Microsoft created this 2-in-1 product, they actually gave the engineering schematics to other PC vendors. That's why you see a lot of copycats on the market. It's not because they're copying Microsoft. Well, technically they are, but they were given those engineering schematics so that they can create versions of their own. And it's done very well for Microsoft because now we have a lot of beautiful 2-in-1s to choose from. Now look, this is a beautiful product, but it's not much of an upgrade over the Surface Pro 8, which is why I want to start this video with Best Buy's top deals, because some of these deals are going to make a lot of sense by the end of the video. So thank you, Best Buy, for sponsoring this portion. Now the Microsoft Surface Pro 8 with 16 gigabytes of RAM, i7, 256 gigabytes of storage is retailing for $1,200. This is $400 off. If you don't want the Pro, there's also the Surface Laptop 4 with the Ryzen 5, 16 gigabytes of RAM, retailing for $900. This usually is sold for $1,200. Probably the craziest deal of all, if you're into gaming, is the ASUS ROG Strix G15 Advantage Edition. This is a Ryzen 9 5980HX, 16 gigabytes of RAM, and an RX 6800M GPU. Usually retails for $1,700, but right now you can get it for $600 off at $1,100. Also, the ASUS ZenBook 15, which I showed in a previous video, is still on sale for $699, and that nets you an MX450 dedicated GPU. Links to all of these products will be in the description down below. So this cobalt blue is a very classy color. It's vibrant, it pops, it's contrasty. I think a lot of people are gonna like this. The design and dimensions are fairly similar to the previous one. If I place the Surface Pro 8 on top of it, it feels the same, right? Like there's not a lot of difference in terms of weight, maybe grams difference, but you're not gonna feel the difference when you have both in your hand. It looks like they flipped the motherboard though, because the ports are now on the opposite sides. So on the new version, instead of having the Type-C ports on the right-hand side, it's now on the left-hand side. The benefit of the Pro 9 is you get two Thunderbolt 4 ports, which you didn't get on the previous version. It was just regular USB Type-C. And of course you have your Surface Connect port. There's one thing you should notice is that the audio jack is no longer available on the Surface lineup. They completely gotten rid of it. So if you wanna connect headphones to this, you either gotta use wireless headphones or use some sort of dongle. There are some minor changes to the vents. It looks like they're a bit wider on the Surface Pro 8. It could just be the color and my eyes, but it looks like the gap between the front of the display and this back portion over here is wider than the Surface Pro 9, which is kind of weird because this thing needs as much air as possible since it's such a thin form factor. Another tweak is the hard drive. If you want to get access to your NVMe SSD, you had to use a pin to pop this cover in order to replace it. With the new version, you don't need that. You just push this little circle, you get this satisfying boingy noise, and then you can take off the cover and access your SSD. As you can see here, they also flipped exactly where that SSD goes. There's no change in the hinge. It feels nice and sturdy, and it goes back just as far as the previous model. Now, there is a little variation between the Intel model and the ARM model. They both come with 1080p cameras, but only the ARM model has Windows Studio Effects. Windows Studio Effects gives you cool utility like being able to auto frame you, follow you around when you're on a Zoom call. You don't get that with the Intel version. The reason being is because the Intel version doesn't have an MPU, which is very specific to the ARM processor that's inside of the other version of this. So you're just gonna get the regular 1080p webcam, which looks good, but you're not gonna get any of those auto frame features. Now, because this is a Surface product, if you want the full experience, you have to spend another $280 to pick up the Surface keyboard. It does come with the Slim Pen 2, which is a very awesome writing tool. I love using this pen for notes. It's one of my favorite pens to write with on the market. I like it better than the Apple Pencil for notes, not drawing. And this is a 120 hertz display. So the only thing I can suggest to you is if you want the best pen experience, make sure that 120 hertz is on because it's the smoothest. When I took this out of the box, it was 60 hertz. And I could tell right away that there was a bit of latency when I was drawing on the screen. But if you put it on 120, it just makes writing notes even better. The keyboard has a nice tactile feel on the keys. Obviously, it's a very shallow travel distance because it has to be embedded into this actual cover. The touchpad is very accurate and easy to use, but it's a tiny touchpad, so you don't have a lot of space to move your fingers around. The display is absolutely gorgeous. It's the same Pixel Sense display you got on the previous Surface Pro 8. It's bright, it has good color accuracy, it has good color gamut. It's a much better display than the one that's on the Surface Laptop 5. Also, another hardware change is the placement of the power button and volume rocker. It's now on the top of the Surface instead of the sides. I like this better because let's say, you know, you take your Surface out of the back, you open up the hinge, and you know right away that if you place your finger like this, you're gonna select the power button. And you know right away that if you place your finger here, you're gonna touch the volume controls. This is very similar to an iPad. But performance is where things start to get a little bit interesting. You would think with an i7 12th gen CPU and faster DDR5 memory and a slightly faster NVMe SSD, you would get, you know, a nice boost in performance compared to the previous model. But the fact of the matter is, I'm not seeing any difference at all. Sure, in synthetic benchmarks, this new Surface Pro 9 just completely destroys the Surface Pro 8. But when you start actually using it for specific applications, the Surface Pro 8 sometimes actually beats this out. In fact, when I was compiling Mozilla Firefox on this, it performed slower on the new Surface Pro 9 compared to last year's model. Video editing was a little bit better on the previous model compared to this one too. Now, this is where things also get interesting, and that's heat management. Microsoft is super conservative with this device. This thing gets a little bit warm, a bit too quick, and if you're really pushing this thing, it's gonna get hot. In fact, I couldn't even run Ada 64 on this to test stability because the application would just lock up and shut down. The same thing happened on my Surface Laptop 5 review. This is not meant for hardcore tasks. It's really for the office user, the dude who's sitting in there typing Excel notes all day, wants to use the pen to take notes, and that's about it. Like, don't buy this to edit video. Don't buy this to handle large amounts of Photoshop files. It's strictly a productivity device. And one thing that I was shocked to see, though, was battery life. Battery life on the previous version was better than this. Like, don't get me wrong, battery life on both are good. Like, I got over 10 hours of use before needing to charge, but I got over 12 hours with the Surface Pro 8. So if that's something you value first, the Surface Pro 8 becomes the better deal. Look, I love this thing. I really do, but it's hard for me to recommend the Surface Pro 9 over the Surface Pro 8 while there's still a lot of supply out there. You're getting better battery life. You're saving $400 for the exact same SKU, and you still get a headphone jack. You're not really getting any benefit with the Surface Pro 9 except for Thunderbolt 4, if that's something you actually need. So while supplies last, if you're looking at the Pro, I would personally go for the Pro 8 while you can. If time flies down the road and there's no more Pro 8 left and you're coming from an older product, obviously go for this, but it's hard to not recommend $400 off for a very similar experience. And look, I get it. You know, Microsoft wants to deliver a specific type of experience. They want to make sure fan noise is low. They can't really push this thing too hard because of how thin this chassis is. So they have to really be conservative with those thermals. And until Intel or AMD gets more efficient processors, more performance per watt, this is what we have to kind of deal with in a chassis like this. I hope that answered all of your questions. If you want to check this out or the Surface Pro 8, there'll be links in the description down below along with all the deals from Best Buy. Like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next one.